Hi, I'm Heather, one of the systems engineers here at Pessler. In this video, I'm going to walk you through creating a PRTG cluster. If you would like to have some more background information on our cluster, we have a lot of information on our website about that. So this video, I'm going to show you step by step how to create it. Okay, let's get started in creating a PRTG cluster. Just so you know, you can see here in the manual on our website, we do have the full step-by-steps to make a cluster. So if I'm going a little too fast and you're not sure what's going on, feel free to go on the website with that. Also on our website, we do have a lot more information on the theory and design of how our cluster works in PRTG. So to make this video better, I do need two VMs. So sorry that the VMs are a little bit smaller on the screen because I do want to have both side by side since we're going to need a master and a failover server in the cluster. So this was the easiest way we thought that we could illustrate this to you. So a few important things before we get started with the cluster that we should go over for PRTG. They both need to be the same version of PRTG. So let's take a look here at my two servers. We can see here that they both have trial licenses because you have to have the same license level in PRTG. And let's go back and take a look at our version of PRTG. So if I go into system status on both, I could see here I am running the same version. Also, you have to have both servers be either 32-bit or 64-bit. You can't have a mix with them when you have a cluster. All right, so now that we're back at our device trees here, it's important to have TCP port 23570 open on both servers so they can talk to each other. That is the cluster port. You may have heard of us talking about port 23560 many times when it comes to remote probes. Also, any remote probes that will go to both halves of the clusters have to have port 23560 open, but the cluster port is 23570. All right, also you have to have your both servers in the same time zone. Even if they are in different parts of the world, in different time zones, the servers need to be set in the same time zone. So all of this is documented on our website. And let's see, I just wanna make sure we cover all the prereqs first. And also the SMTP server for notifications has to be available to both servers if you want both half of the clusters sending notifications. Now that we got through that, let's start building the cluster. This is one of the times that you actually use the PRTG administration tool. I know most things we usually do in the web interface or you use the desktop client, but here, if you go into the start menu on your Windows server and go down to your PRTG folder, you'll find the administration tool there. So we're gonna go to cluster here. We're gonna hit the button to create a PRTG cluster. It's just saying, do you want to proceed? And this is going to be our master. We're going to say yes. So you can see the cluster port here, 23570. So you do have an option to change it if that port is in use in your environment already, but we do recommend keeping the default port. And this cluster access key, make sure you copy that because you will need that later again. So give that a copy, say okay. And now you can see that it is configured to run as primary after restarting the services. It's going to stop the core server service and restart it. And you can see here that PRTG is now restarting. Okay, so now you can see that there is a cluster probe in here and a cluster probe device as well. So it takes a few minutes for everything to get connected and refreshed and get started. So what we're going to do now, let's take a look at here you can notice if you go under the system administration, there is a cluster option that you can go into it as well. And see the cluster is option. The is node state is active here and you have your node ID. And we'll give this a few minutes for everything in the new cluster probe to catch up and be connected. So what we're going to do is go to the second half now of our cluster, which is going to be our failover server. On the failover server, make sure you don't have anything else on it because pretty much it's going to get wiped out because it's going to be failover. So everything on the master will be replicated. So it's easiest just to have a blank install of PRTG with the same license level and the same version of PRTG. So here we will pull up the administration tool and say, join a PRTG cluster. And it's going to say, you're going to do this to become a failover node. You see the message? We say yes. And here you're going to need the master IP address or the DNS name. So I'm going to just put in my DNS name for my server here. You have your port. And now remember when we copied that cluster access key, paste that here. So that's where that becomes very important. And then we will hit join. So it's saying now it's configured to run as a failover node. You say okay. It's stopping the service and restarting the service as well. All right, so after you have the failover join and it reboots, we need to make it active. That's the last step that we have to do. So we go to the setup here, and remember we are in the cluster menu. I will show you again where we go for that. Under system and administration, cluster. And this is a really important step. It's a small step, but I've missed it in the past and spent hours trying to figure out what's going on. You see now the node here appeared in line 2, or before that was blank, for in the node ID for your secondary failover server. You simply have to hit active here and say save. Now you also notice that we do have for lines 3, 4, and 5, because you can have up to a 5-way cluster in PRTG. Every PRTG license includes one cluster failover node, but you would need extra licensing options if you get for 3, 4, and 5. You'll need an extra license of whatever license level you have in PRTG. So you know that, but it is, you're able to do that. So we have that here, we saved it. Come over here, now let's log in. And now you can see here the cluster probe is on here instead of the local probe. So I'm going to go back on this half also, and you can see here my cluster probe's here. It's all green and good health. This is still discovering and replicating over, but you will. So everything that gets connected to the cluster probe is here on this cluster probe. So in PRTG and the cluster, they each halves of the cluster do pull independently to your devices. So they do have their own databases, but your configuration of PRTG does get replicated to the other cluster. So as I said before, we have here on the website for the manual a step-by-step for how to set it up for everything I just went into, as well as further cluster documentation to explain how our clusters work in PRTG. And now you can see that everything on both half of our clusters are all in green and in good health. It does take a few minutes for everything to sync up and come up, but then therefore you have a good healthy cluster. So thank you for watching this video. And if you have any questions, please contact us at support@pestler.com. If you find this video helpful, feel free to like it and consider watching our other videos on our channel. If you still have questions, please contact support@pestler.com. And always feel free to comment for feedback or suggestions for other topics. Thank you.